So that's 1.5 cups of flour, a little bit of salt, shortening, and then I used a tablespoon of water. Then you're supposed to put it into a ball. Oops. Put in 1 cup of flour and then 1/2 cup of flour. Put in 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 cup of shortening. Hard to tell if you've really got 1/2 cup. Voila, it's time to make the apple crumble for Ruth's apple pie recipe. Got brown sugar, flour, and butter. Finished apple crumble. Time to make the pumpkin pie mix. Eggs, sugar, a little bit of salt, pumpkin pie spice, evaporated milk, peeling apples for the apple pie. I was just telling Becky I'm the typical man at age 67 doing something for the first time that I've always let other people do for me. So of course I would like to receive a medal or at the least a tribute video. This seems like the tricky part. How this is gonna work. Foreign service officers, civil service, that's where they come in. It's come to my attention that I might be doing this all wrong. So we're now gonna make a second attempt with parchment paper. Close enough. Got a little problem area over there. I think we can correct it. Well, we MacGyvered the crust. Now I'm attempting to flute it. Fortunately, I have nice relatives who will probably tell me this is a good pie. All right, let's see if I learned anything from the first time. A little better. What does this do?
Okay, it keeps the pie from bubbling up. That's enough on that.
All right, pie crust again. Mixing in sugar, cinnamon, nutmeg, lemon juice with the apples. Pretty soon these will be going in the crust that we just baked, which is right over there. Got the spots here, and then the crumble goes on top of this. Okay, protecting the top of the crust. Well, this is probably not exactly the way Ruth Albers would have done it, but we are trying it in her honor. Let's pour the mix in.
Don't overfill it.
The apple pie is out. Ruth Albers' crumble. Gotta say, paying $20 for a pie seems like a bargain.